Hi, you're watching the IT Taster channel. I'm John, and in today's video I decided that I would leave the studio and pick a really nice spot outdoors to talk about learning styles. Now, as IT people, we're generally always studying and improving ourselves, and it's really important to know your learning styles, particularly when you're studying for an IT certification, because when you're in a classroom environment, a teacher, lecturer or instructor will be able to cater for all learning styles and they'll build that into their teaching. But when we self-study, we're buying our own resources and our own materials, and it's really important to make sure that, you know, we know our learning styles and we're buying the right things to help us with our courses. So in order to do that, I'm going to talk about a learning model known as Vark, V-A-R-K. Now, Vark was proposed in the 1980s by a gentleman called Neil Fleming, and what it does is categorise four learning styles. They are visual, auditory, read-write and kinesthetic, and I'll just briefly go through what they mean. Now, visual learners tend to learn by obviously charts, diagrams, PowerPoints, and they memorise things visually. That's very important to them. Auditory learners, on the other hand, like conversation, they like listening to people. Things like podcasts really appeal to them too. The R in VARK stands for read-write, and read-write learners tend to like to read books, they like to carry out a lot of detailed research, and they like to make notes. And finally, kinesthetic learners. Kinesthetic learners tend to be very hands-on, and they like to learn by doing. Now, when it comes to categorising your learning style, it doesn't mean that you must fit into one of those boxes. You know, for example, I'm a visual learner, but also I like to take notes and I like to do research. And also, as an IT person, I do like the hands-on side of things because it's really important to test what you're doing in the real world. So you will find that a couple of these, one or more, learning preferences will be dominant, but if you know that, you can then look at choosing resources that may suit you, or at least will help improve your learning process. And it's also important to be aware that there are things that can detract from that as well. For example, if you're an auditory learner and you like to learn by listening, if you're in an environment that is noisy and there are a lot of distractions from noise, that's quite irritating for most people, but if you're an auditory learner, that can really bother you and distract from your learning. Again, if you're a visual learner, flickering lights in an environment or poorly produced materials will impact on that too. It is well worth taking a little time to discover your learning preferences. You're probably aware of some of them already, but some you may not be, and when you do know your learning preferences, you can then start to develop a strategy to help you with your self-study. You may find that you may invest in some podcasts, or perhaps a certification book maybe for you, or even videos, or a combination of them. I find learning strategies as a trainer something that is really, really interesting to me. So I'm interested to know what your learning preferences are. Drop a comment below. Also, I'm interested in your comments as well, whether you like the new environment and this style of video. Give it a thumbs up if you did like the video, and don't forget, if you haven't already, please subscribe to the IT Taster channel. Please remember to hit the notification bell, because that will notify you of new videos. And as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.